They did deserve the SLTV final win.
Ooh, we're getting started with the game though. It's Titan versus Ninjas in Pyjamas. We're starting it off on Nuke. Yeah. Best of three in this quarterfinal for the DreamHack Summer Counter-Strike Global Offensive Tournament. And we have Ninjas in Pyjamas starting off on the terrorist side here. And if we check the overview, we can see they are actually playing a bit of a spread game here. Only exists just poking around outside. Oh. And look at this Kenius USP sniper.
You can see, yeah, so the good. CTs are playing very deep. Scream, easily getting that shot there from window. Oh, no, I haven't. So, I mean, that deep play there by the CTs, it's really the standard CT play there on a pistol bomb, but they're able actually to go into the bomb site and plant the bomb. They've given them, goodness me, that's actually quite a good nade. Get right's only on 1 HP. And there are 5 CTs left. Now all they have to do is retake the bomb site before the bomb explodes. For Flarent, here at blue. Goodness me, it's a massive firefight here. Get right getting 2 kills with only 1 HP, but he's finally finished off there by MBK. It's the pistol run for Titan. Very important that Titan won that, or else it would have been a disastrous start to this game.
There was some Mario action going there, just jumping on heads all over the place. It's not how the game works, right? It's not Mario.
You don't kill him like that.
But this is a huge relief here for Titan. On the CT side, picking up the pistol round, they're going to go comfortably into, of course, their buys here. And we can see a couple rifles again. You know, they got the long ranges to work with, so you don't want the SMGs. You want to get those rifles. You don't want to get caught by any pistol armor shenanigans. They did get the bomb down, so they're not going to go for pistol armor anyway.
Yeah, it's they're just not going to go for
that one eco. Then comes the buy, and we're going to see the setup here from Titan, and it is. Oh, we have a little bit of aggression
outside,
here.
Yep.
Kenny S, man, he's the man to watch. We'll check him out.
Does he get the kill? No, actually, Smith will do that. They have no idea that Kenny S is behind a boiler, and he gets himself a double kill with a CZ. Very good job by him. And this is basically Titan thinking, well, they're probably going to go for an outside push. They made that guess, and that's why they pushed 2 people outside. Yeah. And they're able to actually take down the bomb, and now get right to the last man standing. An easy anti-eco for the Frenchman. Yep. And it's good that they read that as well.
It's really nice because, again, this is one of those plays where you don't need... again, Kenny S either saving for the AWP, or if something goes bad, he's going to have a bit of extra money for the next rounds to deal with it. And of course, because he has a pistol, he's got the least money on him. So you can do aggressive, risky stuff with him. You can push him into positions, get that information. That's exactly what happened. Kenny S was up close. He got the frags because he's Kenny S. But had he not got those frags, what he would have been able to tell his team is that, look, guys, there's 3 guys on the outside. Then his team, because the CT side is all about information. They want the perfect defensive setup. To do that, they've got to get the information. That's what Kenny S was doing in that round, as well as, you know, pulling off some awesome shots. Yeah, so 2-0 now the score.
Easy peasy. Easy skins, easy life there for Titan. But it now is the real challenge, as we do have a full buy here, my Ninjas in Pyjamas. Titan have to hold their defenses. As Smith gets an early kill on Freiberg, we have Kenny S holding outside, holding garage. Shooting through the smoke. This shot will miss. Cheeky little get right there on top of the boiler, get shot down by Kenny S. Exist actually, getting the better of... Oh, Forrest actually getting the headshot on Kenny S. He was waiting for him to move into that position. And now it's a 3-on-3, and it looks a bit open. MBK still holding ramp, but outside is pretty much open for business. Only Smiths is there, pretty deep, trying to hold them off. Forrest will take him down. This doesn't look very good here for Titan, because right now they have a choice. They can easily go into bombsite B. There's not really much to stop them. Only Scream here at main. And MBK actually going back outside. This is a huge mistake here by MBK, because he's going to die, sacrifice himself, and now it's all up to Scream. The headshot hunter himself. The head hunter would be a better phrase. But will he be able to defend the bombsite? They're actually going to bombsite A. It's pretty stubborn here, but sadly, Forrest actually going big with 4 kills. He's the one who got the round for Ninjas in Pyjamas, and this isn't a nice start here by Titan.
Definitely, it's going to be really annoying for them now. I mean, they lost so much money there. They did, and the thing is that when you lose the AWP so early after the purchase, you just don't get any return at all on that investment. It just doesn't make you money. You lose a lot of money. And if we look at their economy now, they're kind of broke. They can't play the map how they want to play it. It's a bit of a force buy, not a lot of nades. So this is a huge round for NIP. If they are able to take this, and they have every right to do so, they're going to be winning that second round, winning 2 rounds to 2, forcing an eco from Titan, and things start to get really hairy. So, oh, nice from Fifflerin, just tapping down Existence, you know, calling out Scream over there, as there is another player close by. But this picking game is very, very, very effective on ramp, and Fifflerin even getting MBK low. He's going to realize that. So NIP, very good start there. Fifflerin really opening up the map for them and forcing some rotations. You can see the movement here as they try to stay tight on the upper bomb site. But it's just a matter of time until NIP get in the positions they want and call the shots for the aggressive plays. They're gathering together here now, we can see.
And I think it was really the mistake earlier on in the third round, when Kenny S was just a bit too aggressive with the AWP. He should have just stayed back and kept a more defensive position and stayed alive. And after he was shot down, outside became very open game for them. But now they do have control of the bomb site. There is somebody here in Toxic, and they have no idea about that. The CTs are very viable. They can definitely retake the bomb site from them, as Smiths will be waiting for the right moment for his team to retake the site. Kenny S taking down Forrest, and Scream taking down Freiburg. Now it's all up to Scream and Smiths to retake the site. If Scream is able to get this kill, it'll be a lot more viable. Scream here, the headhunter, unable to find the headshot. It's Smiths against Exist. Is he going to do a fake defuse, or is he going to go for the full defuse? Exist has no idea. Is he going to check? He doesn't hear the second. He opens the door, playing around with Smiths. He's not able to get the final shot on him, and it looks like it's going to be a round for Ninjas in Pyjamas as Exist finishes off the job. There wasn't enough time, and there's no defuse kit there for Smiths. 2-2, and Ninjas in Pyjamas are looking very strong on this heavily CT-sided map.
Definitely. So we're going to see a very, very, just, you know, terrible pistols here, nothing else, no. I think, okay, there's one grenade there on Existence, so that's probably going to be a flash going in for Lobby, so they can aggressively peek into Lobby, get some kills. So that's usually how this goes. Let's check out Existence. Is he going to flash his mates into Lobby? No, he's not actually pushing at all here, so I guess it's just going to be used a bit defensively, just to even up the money a little bit, perhaps. Either way, Titan going to be looking for big results very soon, because if things get out of control, then NIP start pushing that five round or more advantage, then yeah, that's not a happy situation to go into the second half with. That's not what they want. But of course, as you noted previously, the Ninjas, they are fantastic nuke players. It's always been a really dominant map for them. And Kifferin again, working that ramp, catching some kills. Here they go in for that frag for the trade. Really nice reaction there from the French players. And can they actually get anything else out of this? Another frag would make this all worthwhile, but it slows down.
Yeah, it's an eco round here by Titan. It's the stroke of desperation by the Frenchman, who, well, at least Kenny S was able to pick up a gillet. As we've heard before and many times, 2-3 kills on an eco round is good enough. Kenny S actually deciding to save the Galil all the way at CT spawn. That's a good choice by him, trying to keep the CT economy bolstered. An economy that's harder to really keep under control than the T side economy, which can be bolstered every once in a while by a bomb plant here and there, even if you lose the round, even on an eco. System seeing if we can get an exit frag here. Does quite a bit of damage on Get Right, but it's not enough. 3-2 for Ninjas in Pyjamas. And it's not a score you want to see on D-Nuke.
No, it's not at all. We're going to see some money here, and MBK is going to get that drop onto Existence with the AWP here. So, or no, he's going to get it onto Kenny S, right? Okay, that's what you would expect. Kenny S with the AWP. Is he going to go aggressive this time again? Not, you know, we don't see head armor on any of them. Of course, that's because the AK is a one-shot kill on the head. So Kenny S is going to go for the ramp AWPing. And I actually like this much more for Kenny S, actually, being the ramp AWP, because I like that they give outside away more. And, you know, you rely more on players like Get Right to make the long-range shots with the rifles, as opposed to, you know, risking Kenny S out there. Instead, Kenny S can make really good shots down into the lower bomb site if they do go secret, if they give away outside. The only awkwardness for Kenny S is if upper gets taken really fast. And Freiburg to take down Smiths here. And they are controlling the outside and going lower. So this could be an interesting situation here.
You see, Smiths didn't have to die there. You know why? Because they're going to give away outside. Kenny S knows they've given away outside. That's why you have Kenny S here waiting for them to go into the bomb site. So why would Smiths push? Well, maybe he was thinking that he'd get them off guard. Here, we do have the T's slowly taking control of bomb site B. Kenny S holding a horrific angle for the terrorist. This is really, really painful. He's got one person behind the boiler. Oh, what a shot there by Kenny S as he takes down Exist, but Forrest will get the better of him. And Forrest today has been playing the game of his life, as you can really discount most of the rounds to his pure genius with an AK-47. 3-2 here. He's in Pyjamas one round ahead. And also, one man less as Get Right and Fifflerin seeing if they can get enough room to plant the bomb. Is Getright going to move towards bomb site A? Well, that'd be a huge mistake, and the CTs would have called it correctly. Scream.
I like the little pop flash in for Getright to clear out the vents. Teamwork coming in from Fiffler and Getright in these very, very crucial moments here for NIP. They could be carving in quite a lead should they win this one,
but
the French side is strong and they do get the retake. Very important. They must be breathing a huge sigh of relief right there. I want to see, you know, the cameras. I'm sure there's some DreamHack cameras on them right now.
I think his hand was kind of like shivering there. Did you see him? He got the diffuse and then it kind of went off and it went back on. He's like, oh, I can't believe I got this round. But Existence doing a great job getting a double kill and destroying the Clutch Master himself. Getright, who's on 5 kills, actually 5-5 for him. Forest is on 6. This is 4-2-2. On the other hand, Titan are not doing so bad as well. Kenny S, 6 kills, and it's really up to him. If he wants Titan to win, he has to carry. Kenny S, you know, we've seen him. He's such a talented player, and he has so much skill with that off, and also with a rifle. Early kill him on for Flaren. And this is the kind of CT side we want to see. We want to see that first pick. We want to see them having the pretty much winning every single one-on-one peek that they get. Right. They do have the better angles. But it looks like it might be a push into Secret from outside. Smith's able to take out Freiburg at Secret. And this is good. Let them take outside. Let them push into Secret and let them go towards bombsite B. We can take you inside. We can get the better angles. We can back away. We do have the space and we do have the room. And this is what why Nuke is such a CT-sided map. They can always back away and get a better angle. And the T's going into the bombsites can get attacked from so many angles as well. But Forest is taking it easy right now with the AWP. Exist holding his position, seeing if the CTs make a mistake. And right now, the CTs have to take it easy.
Look how much they flash for each other. You know, NIP has such good team play, such good coordination. They got that chemistry going. And there's only 3 players left alive for them. And indeed, you know, having Smith just rush down to Secret through ramp straight away at the start of the round, they indicated they want these defenses inside, just as you said. And NIP now making their way slowly into the lower bomb site. It's going to require some really sick shots here because, to be honest, Titan know exactly what's coming. They are going to be able to have some good spots to deal with this. Look at this. Smith's in a really nice position here. Do they spot this in time? Smith is going to execute. Only what doesn't get a single kill there. And that's still 3 players left alive. They are weak, though. They are wounded. But the ninja's still ninjuring on as Getright gets a double in the vents. And that is so horrible. But Existence with a double of his own. And Getright is forced to a 1-on-2 with absolutely no health. But the bomb is down.
Oh, yeah, yeah, MBK will take him down. Very well played by the Existence because he really kind of saved him there. And we've seen it again and again. That drop down onto vent, if there's a T waiting for you, and usually it's Getright, you're going to be in a lot of trouble. It's going to be much easier for the terrorist to take you down than for you to take him, especially when you're going down that ladder. But a very important round there for Titan. That's going to force the terrorist on an eco, which might make Titan go up 5-3. And slowly start making the lead. They do not want to give Ninjas in Pajamas terrorist rounds. They want to keep it as low as possible. And best case scenario for them is to go through 12-3. 3 rounds already is actually quite a number, especially for Ninjas in Pajamas. It does give them room to breathe, especially early on in this game. And if Ninjas in Pajamas can get 5, that would be perfect.
And we can see the smokes here and a small push outside. Again, my arrow is as accurate as ever. We have Kenny Yester. Let's just jump onto him. He should be spotting some players here. There they are, the next ray all the way through the smoke into Garage. Kenny Yester is tracking their movements, looking for the shot. There goes the edge out. Oh, and Kenny, yes, good as ever, never missing. And that's going to be a good start to the round for them.
What a fast shot there
by Kenny
Yester. Of course,
the money for Ninjas is terrible right now, very bad. But this is really the moment that we can see Titan re-establish themselves in the game economically. Oh, Kenny has to miss one, but that's still okay. He's got a good position. He can fall back, and his teammates are there to give him the support that he needs. And look at that. They're all adjusting. They're going to be double peeking these angles now. And again, another shot. And Titan looked like they got things under control.
The thing with the outside is now that Titan have pretty much 2 of the rounds Titan lost were when they tried to contest for outside and they were outgunned by the Ninjas in Pajamas players. If they really give them outside and let Kenny S take a very, very nice and deep position, they end up doing very, very well indeed. Now, Kenny S already with 3 kills this round, actually 2. Smith's finishing off the job. And so he's slowly getting into the groove of things. And once Kenny S starts really getting those kills with that AWP, he becomes a pretty formidable force indeed. So Ninjas in Pajamas actually going for that buy the round before. We miscalled it, said it was an eco. They actually went for a buy. Now they'll have to go on an eco. And now Titan can go 6-3 up. So they beat them again on that kind of half full buy. They bought as much as they could for Flyer and wasn't able to afford a gun. They have to play the CZ. Now it looks like it might be a fast ramp push here by the eco route. Kenny S is outside, won't be seeing any action. MBK is going to be completely obliterating them there. Gets himself a triple existence, actually with a double. And existence is the one with the triple. And that was an easy anti-eco here for Titan.
So now we are going to expect Ninjas, after they've been testing Titan, testing their defenses, they've realized that Titan made the adjustment outside. So, you know, they had that early success outside Titan. They put a tighter defense, they're letting outside happen. They're pushing Smiths in to defend Secret from inside Secret and not from outside. So they get, Luna, how are they going to adjust to this? They had some success picking on ramp. We're probably going to see something similar here as they do take over lobby. And I think we just saw Freiburg there trying to poke in. And actually, look at this. This is a big tell here. Get right. Again, we saw these plays before with these flashes. This is the upper push right here as Get Right's teammates flooding Get Right on the most outermost man flanking now. Good moves from him as he does take down the player by Vents. It's a 3-on-3 now and the bomb should be going down. No, it got dropped just by Kenny S. How in God's name did he accomplish that one? It is just him left now. And with a CZ, he's going to make it happen with only 9 points of health remaining. Kenny S, the star of Titan, rising to new heights against NIP. 7-3. And this is looking good for Titan. Their economy is getting underway here. But
absolutely
NIP,
amazing.
They're breathing down Titan's necks. They're letting them know that one full step and they are done.
Yeah, yeah. And it's good that Titan have started to get that lead. It's good that they're getting the 7 rounds to Ninjas in Pyjamas 3, because earlier it was 3-2. It wasn't looking very good at all. But now that they've gotten the momentum, if they're able to secure 12 or 11 rounds going into the second half, it's viable for both teams. It really is.
Nice play, Fifflerin. Fifflerin is very good at so far in this game at picking ramp just by himself, taking those jewels. You know, winning the jewel against MBK there on ramp. Really good stuff there. That you know, before when that happened, they slowly punched their way through. You know, Fifflerin ended up dying, but the rest of his team already realized the job that he'd done at ramp, and they used that hole he created and moved through it to gain some ground to make a push onto the lower bomb site. And this may be another round where we see something similar, but they are taking out as well. They're picking out the yard. So much map control here for Ninjas. They have so many options going into this now. So let's see what they go for here as they are lining up a couple players to move in. It looks like we're going to have a split onto upper. We've got some players coming through main, which is Forest, and the rest coming out through upper. This is looking strong. And again, Freiburg makes the frag happen. Fifflerin again with two frags this round now as he smokes the upper, the ladder catwalk now. It's looking like such a well thought out and executed round here from Ninjas.
Very interesting here. We've just found out that Hellraisers are leading against SK Gaming 13-1. They look like a very, very solid side, and I think that Hellraisers might be making it towards the final.
Dude, it's so great. Again, Markov was like,
We have no strategy. But right now, there is a very precarious situation for the CTs. The bomb is planted. There are two left trying to save the open M4, and they've lost the... Let's try and count. Let's do our mathematics. They lost their 11th round.
Look at the angle. Okay, I love the line. You can see the angle. It's great.
I'd like to give a big thanks to everyone who's currently with us in the stream. It's an absolute pleasure to be casting for you. I hope it is to your enjoyment. And I hope that me and DDK are offering some really nice Monday afternoon entertainment for you. I'm sure some people will agree.
Right, so we've got an interesting situation now. You know, the money's not so strong really for Titan. If they lose this round, you know, again, eco's coming out from them. So this is a really good round for NIP to actually pick up two. If they're able to just get this one, and that pushes them to 6 rounds. That's a really solid result for the T-Half. So this is something that could go very well for Ninjas. Let's see how they're going to start this one out. They're, again, doing a very similar play as the last round. If it ain't broke, don't fix it. Fifflerin, it's been so good so far on Nuke in this match against Titan at picking the players on the ramp. He even smokes it off, and they're playing this one really slow. And there goes the flash as well. Oh, actually, they're going for the upper execution again, it seems. Or are they? I mean, there go all the flashes and smokes, but no players. I think Titan is a little confused right now as to what NIP are doing.
They're really testing Titan's defense at the moment. They're throwing flashes here and there, making them guessing. Keep them guessing. Putting smokes down at ramp, throwing some nades, trying to cause a bit of damage. They've got time left on the clock. It's 50 seconds. They want to keep them moving, but Scream will take the initiative and push into lobby, get himself a double kill. Very, very important there by Scream, because now they have the tough situation of playing an uphill battle against the Frenchman. 5-3 now, but Exist, Get Right, and Forest. Definitely three players you can't underestimate. Kenny S pushing in towards bot site. Very close proximity there. We'll be able to take down Exist. It's a flawless round so far. MBK getting the better of Get right now. The last man standing is Forrest. Who is rocking a hard place there. Forced to kind of jump around all over the place. He's getting attacked from pretty much almost every single angle, but we'll be able to get the better of MBK. We only had a mag 7, so that's not horribly bad. Kenny S with some mad jumping skills, getting away from Forrest in the last second.
The French parkour coming into play.
some parkour by Kenny S. Beautiful little jump.
8-4 now as well, and that was a good round for LIP to really swing things back. But now they're in a spot where it's like, man, look at this buy. This is a pitiful buy, really.
It's very good for Nip, though. It's very good for Nip. You know why?
Why is that?
4 rounds on Nuke is perfect. 4 rounds is good. 4 rounds is very good on Nuke. They can easily win this game with 4 rounds, and they've won. They've won games where they've come back from 15-1, and it was in fact against Titan, 14-1. It was against Titan on Nuke. They came back 14-1 and won the game. So 4 rounds is like heaven for them at the moment. Pushing in on an eco. Scream has no idea what's going on. He's completely flashed. Smith's as well, but he's got 5 Ds in front of him. Will he be able to pick him off? Well, with the help of MBK, they might be able to finish the job. Get right with a Galil. Oh, it's all up to Kenny S, and Kenny S again, the last man standing, will be able to get the round for Titan, and he's been so important for Titan at the moment. He's got 14 kills, MBK was 13, and Smiths was 12, and Scream, the super talent, the headhunter himself, is simply not performing, and we need to see better play here from Scream.
In the last round where we saw them in a position where they could take 6 rounds, where Titan's economy was a bit shaky, and they could have gone to something like a 9-6 scoreline on the T side. NIP, I mean, they were doing this like really interesting play with the grenades and everything, but Scream was like, enough's enough, and just pushed in lobby. Yeah. You never expect that into lobby, just straight up, just no nades, just pushed in and got 2 frags. I mean, that completely just destroyed their play there, and that just change of pace from Titan, just that those risks that freedom that some of their players have, like you were saying, to do their thing, that's what they need, and that's what's happening so far, and they're doing so well because of it. And look at Kenny S outside here with his teammates. They've worked it out. Great coordination now, just gunned down pistoling players. The pistoling Swedes.
And he's made some nasty, nasty shots, Kenny S has. Some really disgusting flick shots here and there. I mean, it is an eco hit by the terrorist side. It'll make Titan go up on 10-4. But still, he's really on point. And I think one thing that Kenny S just has to concentrate on is his positioning in relation to the rest of his team. They've got 5 Molotovs here. Every single player on the team have Molotovs.
So good on this map.
Existence, has he got something in his head? Has he got something planned? Or is this just... something that they've planned before.
Their economy is just so sick, and it's like last round. So and they're so good. Molotovs are so, so good on this map. There's so many good spots in them, especially if you play tight in the side. To inside, lower side, upper side, it's great. And it's like they are just, again, I mean, NIP are going with what was working before. They're just going for the slow take outside because they know that Titan are giving them outside, so that allows them to go for these A splits on upper and main. And here they go. They're going to go for a scream. Oh, instantly taken down there by Freiburg. Wonderful stuff as Existence works main, coming in from behind, but he's smoked off now. Nothing else he can do unless he runs through that smoke. And NIP are looking great on a 3-on-2. And Existence and Smiths are left.
Oh. That was interesting there by Scream. He threw the right flash. He had the right position, but he just didn't get the shot before Freiburg did. Very fast reflexes there by Freiburg, and now it's up to Existence and Smiths. They don't want to go into the second half just with 10 rounds, at least 11. They've got some nades. They've only got 1 nade left. Smiths will get the first kill. It's 2-on-2 now. Not a lot of time left. They have to push him fast. They're against this absolute monster who is Get Right. He will get the round 10-5. This is perfect for Ninjas in Pyjamas.
I swear, Get Right's, like, his recoil, it doesn't work like anyone else's.
He's got a trigger bot.
He's got some magical effect over the recoil. It's just, it's too perfect.
Yeah, but you know he has a trigger bot, right? GetRight.exe. It's called getwrecked.exe. That's his trigger bot. You can Google that. If you find it, you can install it on your mouse.
10-5 though for Titan on the CT side. That's something they can be comfortable with, and it's a scoreline that the Ninjas can be comfortable with as well. Moving into this pistol round, Ninjas, a lot of pressure on them to grab this one, as Titan did when they had their turn to play the CT side. And we can see Fiffler in there on ramp and Freiburg on main. They're not really super tight on upper, actually. So let's see how this goes. And actually, it might be a good call.
Oh, what a shot there by Forrest. I think, really, goodness me, it's complete destruction here on ramp. The thing that we really have to expect is that Existence is able to make those mid-round calls. He's able to make the right calls for his team. This is the only thing that's going to make Titan win this match. I mean, we already predicted that Ninjas in Pyjamas were going to get the better of Titan on Nuke. However, if Titan want to defeat Ninjas in Pyjamas, Existence has to up his game. That's the only thing they can do on the terrorist side is be able to have as much game sense as possible, to know where the CTs are and to know the best mode of action, the best route to take, because there are weak points on this map and there are always weak points in the CT defense. It's just that you don't know them. Here, when with the overmap, we can take a look and walk around and see what's wrong here and there, but you know, as a T, you don't see anything. You have no idea. Smith's very aggressive here on outside of the CZ. Unable to land any significant amount of damage.
Get right pretty hurt though, actually. He's getting kind of low, which is kind of sucks because usually Get Right is very good at controlling the yard from the outer catwalk position. As we can see him in.
We've got a boost here on Heaven. Well, Get Right is going to move out of the way though.
Oh, Scream. He's got armor, you know, head armor as well. As they, you know, they didn't get the bomb down, so they went pistol armor. So kind of have to eco twice anyway. So there it is. Oh, Get Right. Oh, Scream doing the get wrecked right now. Can he get another one?
Quite a lot of damage, but doesn't finish the job on Exist. Smiths does that instead. Well, they're doing not bad for an eco. Well, not necessarily an eco. This is actually a full buy here by Titan.
Yep, this is you know, already, you know, they've done some good stuff here. They've managed to take down two players. That's great. It's good work. Because this is an investment to keep the economy low for the ninjas, to keep them rebuying here, mm-hmm. and not let their economy build. And that disruption is really important because, again, we made the point before, the fragility of the CT economy, and they got the bomb down, and they got that is massive. That's
very
much
good
money for them.
That's very good for them as they're able to kill two of the players, and also plant the bomb. So a relatively successful eco round here by Titan, but 10-7 as Ninjas in Pyjamas slowly decrease the gap between the two sides. The Frenchmen have to do something substantial. MBK, Kenny S, and Smiths all on the same score. And as I mentioned before, one of these players has to do something big. Weirdly enough, if you look at the kills there in Ninjas in Pyjamas, they've got a lot less kills. A lot less. Mm-hmm. Not even a bit less. A lot less, even though the rounds are very similar. But we'll wait and see to the course of action that the terrorists will take.
Yeah, I mean, we can see the effect that those kills had on the economy there for NIP. You know, they're pretty low. They had to rebuy some weapons. A lot of grenades had to be rebought as well. And the Forest going down. Freiburg going down as well. This eco is going really amazingly. Are they going to pull this one off? Titan are playing out of their minds here. This is a big deal for them. And NIP have to be sweating right now because this is terrible for them. They can't buy if they lose this round. And if Titans swing back the momentum at this point in the match, they're going to be on a really, really strong path towards winning this map, to be honest, as they play the EDT half.
Big play there by MBK. And he's made a big play today. He's been putting himself in a good situation. I have no idea where Get Right. It was MBK finishing it off. Yes, MBK will get the round for Titan. Huge play by them. Very good for their economy. And interesting because they didn't actually go for a buy, even though they planted the bomb. It was a full-on eco by them. And they got the round regardless. MBK now on 19 kills. And he's been doing very well indeed. That round was his, really. MBK able to get that. And the round before, he did very good as well, getting Get Right while he was at main. So good job by him and good job by Titan, who are now four rounds ahead. Now with a full buy. MBK playing with the M4 Silence.
And it's one smoke to Get Right on Hutch. Of course, just equaling up the money a bit and even being able to afford the 5-7, like an $800 buy there. And just evening things up because he had quite a bit of money. But overall, you know, we can see that this should in theory go 12-7 score-wise. I mean, and the ninjas should be able to actually take this round. But we'll see what kind of damage they can inflict on Titan, as Titan did just absolutely destroy them in the last round with their pistols. Maybe NIP could do the same thing. They've got the skills to do it. And Titan are making the play on the outside here. Just getting all the map control. Smith is, you know, locking down a ramp in case there's a push with the pistols on ramp. There is the risk if he does get taken down that he loses his weapon. But that's not a huge risk for them. And
Resistance on 2 HP.
Not expecting
that
little sneaky push through the smoke there.
But it's interesting, that smoke wasn't actually very good, the one on secret. So they were able to see that they weren't going through secret. And that let them keep their positions. Only Kenny S has gone through here, getting that kill on Forrest and backing away. Safe play by the terrorist side. They want to plant the bomb. They're going to plant the bomb. He's not going to go for the mad chairs or mad frags. Well, he get the second one anyway. He will be able to get down Freiberg. And Smiths will finish it off with a kill on Get Right. So a pretty good anti-eco by them. Four more rounds to win this game on the terrorist side. Is it possible here for the Frenchman?
They could, like, they have such good money that Titan do. They could even actually go for an AWP to try to pick ramp or something creative like that. But they also know that there can't be anything like an AWP for Ninjas in Pyjamas because their money is so low. So they could actually find quite a weakness on ramp. And actually, look, in fact, NIP kind of predicting this, with a pre-Molotov there, some pre-nades to really stop an aggressive pick, push for a pick. And it really looked like Titan were going for that. They had a couple players, moving quickly towards ramp, but the smoke and the Molotov, was a stopping point for them. And Titan just gaining all the map control that they can so that they can make a good decision. And maybe NIP can actually, in the midst of this map control play from Titan, actually put a sneaky position to surprise them. And actually, that's exactly what happened. Forrest, working the Alistair catwalk there really amazingly. There's a third frag from Forrest. Fifthler, and can he win his one-on-one? Here he goes, and he does it. Fifthler in the master of ramp so far, and MBK's left all on the lonesome. But the thing is, though, is that there's still a lot of bank for the terrorist side here. So MBK is now on a mission to inflict economic pain as he is going to force Forrest to rebuy. And Freiberg's already got to rebuy next round as well.
It's the French Rambo at the moment, trying to wreck as much havoc as he can. Oh, he gets the headshot on Exist. This is pretty painful here for the CT side. They're paying the price to take down the French Rambo. MBK now, last man standing with his M4. Using the weapon of his enemies to take them down one by
bullets.
One.
No,
he's not got a lot of bullets. Well, he's got more bullets on his CZ, yeah. But that as well.
It's a bad sign, isn't it?
It's not a good sign yet. If your CZ is the most ammo that you have, then you have to be very careful. But he's able to save the M4, which is very good for the T-side economy.
Oh my God, look at the money for the CTs again. Killing so many players, even though they won the round, they can't even really buy. They have to buy.
The T-side economy is better.
Really.
Yeah, exactly. You're right. But the T-side economy is actually better, even though they lost that round. And that's a good situation to put yourself in. They're able to get all the nades they need. On the other hand, CTs, well, they're not able to get everything.
Yep. They're prioritizing smokes there and a couple HGs. So I would expect Titan to try to play this slow and bait out the nades and just, use all the time to get rid of all those nades. Because they should be able to figure out that there can't be a huge amount of them. There's only a few nades left, about eight nades left in total, four flashes and a couple HEs and a couple of smokes, and that's it. So they got loads of time to try to get rid of those. There's another smoke going down.
It's just slowing down the incoming Titan movement, or trying to force Titan to play in a certain way. Smokes you can use to control the map, to force certain plays, or to protect yourself. You can almost seem to know what they're doing here. Screen pushing in through garage. They're not going to go through secret. Only one man is doing that. And that's good for them because a fast push into secret usually ends up in disaster, especially if the CTs know what's coming. Smiths is still in ramp just in case there's a rotation here by the CTs. And it's really, it's something you want to do as a CT. You're like, oh, well, there's a lot of sound. Fifflarin almost with a double kill taking out MBK. But you hear a lot of sound outside. You're like, let me try and rotate, see if I can get him from behind. And you get hurt by that rotation, and it could be very damaging. Scream, able to take down Get Right, but Forrest will do the damage on Existence. Now it's a 2-on-3 with 20 seconds left on the clock. They still have the bomb under their control. And Kenny S is going to try and plant it in bombsite B. There's nobody here, and I have no idea. Well, he actually went through secret really easily while the rest of his team made a lot of noise. He was going through secret. Freiberg will take down Scream now. It's all up to Kenny S. It's a 3-on-1 situation for this AWP madman. Well, sadly, he'll be thrown back into the sewage of the nuclear plant, forced to cook.
So there we go. NIP taking one more round.
Yeah.
And
12-9.
They're going to feel happy for sure about that, but they're going to be a bit they're not going to be feeling too comfortable with the fact that Titan are doing so well against their defense here overall. And this is really hard to deal with. You know, when you're playing, I'm sure a lot of players, you know, played competitive Counter-Strike can feel this. Like, when you can't get, and I mean, this is the time, isn't it? Momentum, like constant breaks. They're constantly having breaks. They're able to buy for a couple rounds, and then they lose. Then they buy for, you know, a couple rounds, maybe win a, you know, yep, two or three in a row, but then they lose again. They can't really get this big string of rounds together. That really gets some feeling, you know, in putting them in a good psychological place. One of the differences about teams like this, though, is especially like NIP, is they've got so much experience that they're always able to perform regardless. And we're seeing the smokes go over here to Yard. Let's see if we can find some of those smokes. So Smith again, you know, guarding the flank. There are all the smokes there, as we can see from Existence's point of view. And if you see how hard it makes it for Getright, and Getright's actually just got the best spray in the world. Gets double right there. I'm just screaming Goodness Existence me. From such insane range Goodness as well. Me. And
great. It's not even fair.
Take down from Frybo too. So they're cleaning up house here. And it is not fair, is it? Getright's got amazing control.
Yeah, gives them no chance.
And this is great. I mean, okay, there's the second round in a row there for them. And they've got to keep this going. They just can't let go of this, because they let go of this again. Let's look at this money situation. They're not they're in dire straits here. They're going to have to eco if they start losing.
Exactly. Once they start forcing Titan to eco, it's really game over for Titan, because they can't afford to lose so many rounds. They know they can't string in 3-4 rounds in a row on the T-sided map against Ninjas in Pajamas. They know that for sure. But we have heard that Hellraisers have won the first map against SK Gaming, 16-8 on Inferno. So that's going to force SK Gaming to play an uphill struggle in the next map of that series. But at the moment, we have a push outside here.
Wow.
That's shut down by Forest.
Nice position.
Ryder will actually be killed by Smiths.
I never see people use this position, but Forest is, I think he's going to change that.
How can he see that far? How can you see that? That's such a huge distance to rifle from and get the headshots. But I think it's just practice. It's just knowing where to put the crosshair, knowing where the T's are going to be walking by. And it's really pre-fire more than anything.
And we're seeing a scar here on Getright. And this is going to be quite interesting here, because it's a big investment. And you know, they're starting to build that bank. They feel comfortable. They have the flexibility in their economy to go for big investments. And that if they lose it, it's not the end of the world. So, you know, NIP feeling in a good place right now. And what can Getright accomplish? This changes their setup a lot. We can see Getright on the outside. And we can see there's a double, two players on ramp and two on the upper site here for NIP. So much, much different setup. And Getright
interesting.
Just playing by himself here. Really far back position.
Well, they did a great job putting those smokes that pretty much stopped Getright from really using that scar to any effect. Allowed them to go through into secret. Right now, it's MBK who is leading the score for his team with that Sieg. And he's the man at the moment who has the confidence and has the form to carry his team to a win in this map specifically. He's been playing very well indeed. Existence sees and he catches Getright. First kill for Titan. Oh my goodness, look at this boost here. They're not going to see Forest. He pulls out at the right moment, he'll get a double kill. Forest taking down both MBK and Smiths. And that early kill there by Existence.
Oh, wow.
Absolutely useless.
That is
Forest.
A diabolical boost. And it's horrific. It's just not looking good for Titan after that double kill. They needed that ramp push coming in from that side. And Forest, he's looking to get the triple and shut this down completely, and that's what he was going
to
do.
He's far too good. He's far too on point today. It's all up to Scream right now. He's on a 1-on-3. The headhunter himself, well, going to have his crosshair at the wrong point and at the wrong time. It's 7-2 here for Ninjas in Pyjamas. 12-12 on a very CD-sided map. This is not as equal as the score may seem it or may... Or it may seem, or it may look, but at the moment.
By the way, not a single bullet was released from the scar that Getright bought.
Really, he got shut down well, it was a good shot there by Existence actually.
It was really nice, and here's Fifthrin. Fifthrin hasn't been tested that much. I've got to say, they haven't really pushed hard in, but he's got such good support from Forest. I mean, Titan study the game. They do study setups, and you know, NIP have played so many games on this map that it's an easy team to study this map to play against to figure out their setups. The trick is beating them on those setups.
This is a very dynamic setup as well by the CT side. You've got players going absolutely everywhere. Forest is in ramp, then he's outside, then he's in A. He can be absolutely anywhere. Fifflaren might be in ramp, he might be outside the next round. And this is going to keep Titan guessing. They don't know who they're up against. Freiberg right now waiting in vent. He's going to see Scream right in front of him. Easy kill for him there. 5-on-4 now. This is not looking so good for Titan, but Flaren is going to be tagged relatively well, but he will return the damage on MBK, putting him on 8 HP. Nice nade there on Kenny S. And they're keeping up the pressure.
And they're going to take ramp. Well, they should take ramp. Fifth Room's got to be careful not to, like, rather to survive rather than die and just fall back to some more position. Let Forrest help him. Garrett again. Garrett is so good in that position there. And Existence coming up unexpected through those vents. And now Titan might be able to salvage something here, but it's just Smith left. He's got, again, a good position, but he's against three men here. Three angry Swedes. And Garrett once again just taking them down.
So nothing Titan have been doing. Exactly. Nothing Titan have been doing has been effective whatsoever. And the only time they've really been able to get those rounds is when an unfortunate series of events occurs. And
I would love to see a fast upper take from them. Like, really fast upper take with good smokes and
it
everything.
It won't work.
They're only playing two men on upper, and the ramp guys are far away, usually. So, So upper should be hard to reinforce, and it should be easier for them to take it, because their outside guys have not been in main so often either. So,
but Nip are just going to back away, give them the site, and then retake it. They'll have the better position, they'll have the upper ground. Titan, you know, they've had the trouble of giving too many rounds away to Ninjas in Pyjamas on the T side. This is the main mistake Titan have made. It is a CT-sided map, so it's very difficult to get those rounds, especially against such a disciplined Ninjas in Pyjamas side. And Ninjas in Pyjamas have simply played a better T-sided part of this map. That's really what has happened. And Titan have made too many mistakes on the CT.
And NIP are getting their stride now. Like, you can see all the players are starting to really connect their shots that they hit in their spots. Yeah. And this is like those momentum. We've passed the kind of two rounds in the break and They've got that string going. That confidence is real.
They look like a cohesive body. Honestly, when you see Getright and Forrest play, it looks like they know exactly where the players are. They're pushing in and they're firing just before they take a corner. I mean, their reflexes are far, far too fast. It's either that or they have wall hacks. It's either or. Obviously, on land, they're most likely not going to have wall hacks, and it's definitely going to be their skill level.
And this is the round now, because we're seeing a buy from Titan. They've got no money left. This will be the 15th round win for Ninjas, and there's no money left for Titan if they lose this round. So it's game over after this. This could be the last round, more or less.
Yeah.
This could be the game-deciding round here. For Titan, they've got to do something special here, because what they've been doing so far is not working. They're going to go for an outside play, an outside take, and that is a good place to start for them.
But what next? What after that? What after taking outside, what are they going to do? It's a bit of a confusion there. But after they take outside, what are they going to do? Well, they're going to push into Secret. Secret's going to be given to them. Freiberg is usually waiting there at vents, and he's going to allow them to push through. They're going towards bombsite B. The CTs have caught wind of that, and now they're in position to stop them from pushing into the bombsite. They have Forrest, who's been doing very well for his side so far. MBK on top of Boiler, trying to see if he can catch any rotations from outside, and Forrest will get himself a kill on Existence. MBK and Smith with a kill each. Smith with a second. Now it's 1-on-2. Smith is the last man standing. And it's not going to be good news for Titan, as now they are three rounds behind with not a lot of money and with a match point to play. And I think the game ended when the first half ended at 10-5. That's when the game really ended. When Titan gave away too many rounds for Ninjas in Pyjamas, that's when we thought, well, it's going to be very difficult for them to get six rounds as a tease to win this game. Titan at the moment going for a motley assortment of buys. AK-47s, two of them, two Galils.
Garrett's going to try the scar out again. He's like, all right, last time I didn't even get to shoot a bullet. Already improved. He already shot some bullets, so he's doing better than last time. But he's just aiming slightly too high. Oof. There, unfortunately. But
well,
anyway.
Actually, he did a bit of damage on Existence.
He did, actually. Yeah, that's a good point. So, 32 half there for Existence. But it's a very scrappy buy here for Titan. They haven't really put strong challenges into ramp. I like that they finally get something strong going there. They do manage to take down Fifflerin, but Forrest is still there. And now Getright's got the freedom, because they know that outside's under control, to just rotate with no problem. And can he has
to be patient here. He has to be patient. Looking if he pushes points. Through at the wrong moment, he's going to be in a lot of trouble. This is nice by the Titan side as they push from double doors and from vents at the same time. That's going to force Freiberg to look away and get shot down by Kenny S. Now it's back to a 2-on-2 situation here. Kenny S in existence. This is the match point here for Ninjas in Pyjamas. If they're unable to win this round, Titan, it's going to be game over for this map, and they're going to have to play on Inferno. And an uphill struggle. Kenny S planting the bomb. This is a good start, but get right and exist almost at the same time. We'll get a kill each, and it's GG for this map. Titan lose against Ninjas in Pajamas on Nuke. 16-12, as we had thought, as we had predicted. It's such a strong map here for the Swedish side. Ninjas in Pajamas are so, so good on Nuke, and we know that. It's the highest win ratio that they have. It's up there in the 90s, over 95% win ratio. So it's to be expected. However, Inferno is going to decide the future of this match. If they play Inferno and Titan win Inferno, they'll be playing on Dust 2, which is really Titan's map. If not...
And, you know, actually, Titan has historically had a really good Inferno game. They've been leaders, you know, they've been innovators when it comes to that map. So I'm very curious to see how things plan out. I mean, I think they're using Kenny S a lot better. So I'm really curious to see how...